is really got to the surface.
Welcome to the LinCam TV show, where we focus on organizations looking to make their impact within and around the city of Lynn. Here with me today from the Child Nutrition Outreach Program, we have Ashley Krebs, Director of the Child Nutrition Outreach Program, and Kevin Richardson, Senior Director of Dining Services at the Lynn Public Schools. Now, we're here today to talk specifically about the Summer Food Service Program, which is an outstanding organization, first and foremost, but this program has been developed in order to bring nutrition to children in your communities throughout the entire state of Massachusetts. Ashley, you're the director of the program. First and foremost, I'd like to talk a little bit about the organization itself and its overall function. How does it work? Who do you work with? Tell me a little bit about that.
Sure. So the Summer Food Service Program itself is a federally funded nutrition program. And so on the federal level, it's operated by the United States Department of Agriculture. In Massachusetts, it's administered by the Massachusetts Department of Elementary and Secondary Education. And then at the local level, operated by what we consider sponsors. So in this case, Lynn Public Schools is who operates the program in Lynn. For us, our role, the Child Nutrition Outreach Program, is that we're fortunate in Massachusetts to hold a contract with the Department of Ed around doing outreach for this program because it's underutilized. So we look at ways to look at increasing participation through a number of different strategies. We are available to work statewide with that to hopefully bring access to this program and these locations to more youth.
Collaboration seems to be a big part of what you guys do, and a lot of the outreach is on your end. And you get guys like Kevin, you get lucky enough to have guys like Kevin who can participate and actually help you achieve your goal. I want to talk to, first and foremost, I'm going to ask you, Kevin, a little bit about yourself and how you're involved with the program.
Sure. Well, I work with the Lynn Public Schools as the food service director for the lunch program. As Allison said, there is a sponsor program that the Lynn Public Schools does, and we basically go around the city. We look for sponsors who wants to serve throughout the summer, whether it be breakfast or lunch. And so we basically find those sites, and we go through an application process through the Department of Elementary and Secondary Education, and throughout the whole entire summer, we service those sites.
So there's two aspects to it. You've got the people you need to help and then getting in their neighborhood. So these sponsors that you're talking about, they offer you a venue to actually complete your task.
Correct.
Okay, cool. So Ashley, I want to talk a little bit about just your responsibility and how you're involved and what you do at your level.
Sure. So the Child Nutrition Outreach Program works statewide. Again, we work both around school breakfast and the summer food service program because those are two federal nutrition programs that are underutilized, both nationally, but specifically looking at Massachusetts. And so we will work with communities, if we're talking about the summer program specifically, we'll go in, look at communities that might have eligibility to operate the program that currently do not have one, so looking to start programs throughout the state, or look at communities that have existing programs but might not be reaching as many kids as they could, and so how can we expand it? And we'll provide a lot of technical assistance in that matter, so we'll help facilitate community meetings, engaging key stakeholders, and bringing them to the table to figure out how in a community we can reach more youth. That might be through looking at access, so how do we add more locations, the physical locations where meals are provided. How do we provide more programming to get the kids to the location? So maybe a meal isn't enough and they need more, maybe even something as simple as arts and crafts activity to engage them. We will help with promotion. So awareness might be another huge issue that the community itself just doesn't even know that it is a service that's provided and available for them. So helping with distribution of materials and posters and flyers that have all the different meal locations on it. So we help in a lot of different capacities, looking at ultimately ways to increase participation in that community and throughout the state.
Okay, great. So now when it comes to child nutrition, there's a lot of aspects to it. One, you want to make sure that they're eating the right foods and they're eating enough food.
Sure.
How did this come about? This seems as though this has been a huge part of advocacy throughout the entire country within the last 9 years. What's it attributed to?
Sure. So I think throughout our country and in our state, we have a presence of food insecurity, and we're looking at ways to alleviate hunger. Federal nutrition programs is one way to address hunger in our state. And so the summer food service program itself was first established looking at alleviating those summer, bridging the gap of summer months from the end of the school year to the start of the school year. And so during the school year, many youth can rely on school meals, and whether it be a free or reduced priced meal that they have access to for breakfast and lunch. Then the summer hit and they would lose access to that. So how would these families all of a sudden adjust to this additional food cost that they were otherwise getting through the school year? So the summer program was created to help alleviate that gap and bridge the gap of the summer months, which ultimately is going to help, you know, the children as a whole, looking at the whole student through education, performance, behavior. You know, being hungry is at the root of many things for youth, whether it be development or, again, behavior. So we're looking at how can we ultimately get that nutrition to the youth that need it over the summer months. And okay. It's a topic that you can see nationally, but we focus on Massachusetts as our main area.
You know, I'm not a parent, and I've never even thought about that. I mean, but I went to school, and you know, we all did. Mm-hmm. But yeah, summer months came, and it's just I do remember the summer. You know, you were out playing. You didn't really go and care about breakfast or doing any of that stuff, because your day to day has changed. Your patterns change. You wake up whenever you want. You can do what you want. Considering if your parents allow you to do that. But at the end of the day, you guys are trying to get this information out to these local neighborhoods and allowing them to know, like, hey, we have resources out there for you. So if you're looking to find some information, you guys can give them a call, 617-723-5000. They're on Facebook and Twitter. That's at Child NUTRI. You can also find some more information on their website, www.meals4kids.org. And you can also send out a kind email to CNOP, standing for Child Nutrition Outreach Program, and that's at Project Bread. So guys, I want to talk a little bit about the program specifics. We talked a little bit about the aspects of what you're trying to achieve. One, creating some nutrition outreach advocacy for children throughout the state of Massachusetts, but you're also working alongside to develop sponsors, get people involved in actually being able to help you achieve your goal. So when it comes down to it, we're here today to create some awareness. What type of awareness are you trying to create, and who are you trying to make aware?
Sure. I think we can look at it from different levels. On the state level, we absolutely want to engage legislators and decision makers to ensure that they support the summer food service program and programs like this, that they're aware of it, and that, you know, whether they are making a decision at the state level or at the community level, they know that this program is an asset to their town or city. At the local level, we are trying to engage and make aware the community members, and whether that be people that are in a position to help promote themselves the program, or volunteer, or maybe they have free or low-cost programming they can bring to these locations. There's absolutely an awareness that can be made at that point. But then also the people that could benefit from participating in these programs, that they know their community offers it, or that a nearby community does, and that there's a location that their children can go to receive a free meal or a no-cost meal. So letting them know where are the locations that the program exists, that this is something that happens statewide and nationally, and is a resource to them in their own community. So for Lynn specifically, you know, they are fortunate to have Lynn Public Schools offering the summer food service program and providing nutritious meals throughout the summer months, so that they know, hey, this is, you know, it's a trusted source. They get their children already receiving wonderful meals during the school year. This is now continuing throughout the summer and has been around, and did you know about it? So we absolutely would love for people to know about that and be able to know that this is a resource to them in their own community.
Outstanding. Kevin, what type of value does a program like this bring to a city like Lynn?
I think it brings a great value because, as you mentioned before, typically, you know, when the school year ends, those families that were receiving those benefits as far as free or reduced meals really don't have that opportunity anymore. So this program really it really brings that to them as well as anybody else, because it's basically it's free to any child below 18 and below. So it's, you don't have to have be registered anywhere or enrolled anywhere. You can come to one of these open sites in according to whatever they're serving, breakfast, lunch, and the times of day, you can receive a meal at no cost.
Yeah, it's definitely
so it's a great benefit.
It's something that, you know, I hadn't really taken into consideration, but it's a long month to actually go and have to figure out, okay, well, we just had reduced lunches or free lunches, and now we've got to feed, you know, Jimmy or Sarah until September starts. So what do we do? I think it's outstanding that the Lynn Public Schools is involved. And the Lynn Public Schools is pretty much enveloped into the Lynn community. I mean, when it comes to the kids, that is the focus. That is the number one task at hand for all of those guys, from the truant officers to the principals to the superintendent. It's always going to be about future generations and creating contributing citizens to the city of Lynn. And a lot of these kids, I mean, you might know on a first name basis, you might know, is you can't help but get involved because, one, they're kids and they want to tell you everything. And it's like sometimes you hear something, you're like, oh, wow, that's, I thought I had it hard, but, you know, realistically, it could always be worse. So gaining support, we were talking about this before the program. This is across the whole entire state of Massachusetts. So it's super important that you guys have the advocacy of your organizations as well as community, but you need political figures out there, real leadership level people out there to kind of generate some enthusiasm behind this. So what are you trying to do right now in order to gain support?
Sure. So thank you for asking that. We actually are really excited that this year we're trying to pull together a congressional day for the state of Massachusetts. So whenever we have an opportunity, whether it be a community meeting or an event, we like to invite elected officials or congresswomen and men that it might be their district, and have them have an opportunity to see what's going on in their communities within their district. So far, that has been very well received. People are really interested in being able to come out, interacting with the kids, seeing what's going on. Right. So this year, we're trying to pull that together in a more comprehensive way. We'd love to have a congressional day where we actually have representation from all of the districts. We are really fortunate to have Congressman McGovern in our state, who is a huge advocate for hunger relief and federal nutrition programs. And so he's taking the lead and helping us organize that. And so we're looking forward to potentially pulling those representatives together in the state of Massachusetts on one day so they can go out to the meal locations and actually see the programs in action and the wonderful work the sponsors are doing.
It's going to make it a little easier on you being in a state like Massachusetts where, you know, children are a huge, huge part of the concern. Real quick, we've got about 2 minutes left before we take a break. Brian, I want to talk a little bit, Kevin, I want to talk a little bit about the operations behind the program. You're heavily involved in how the Lynn Public Schools actually pulls us off. So in a nutshell, explain to me the operations that your day-to-day.
Well, once we have a site that's been approved and it's ready to operate, we get their dates, whatever the program is, say, you know, from July 6th to the end of July. So we know basically when they'll be looking for meals. And it's basically, what we do is it's a cold meal, cold breakfast, cold lunch, and we deliver every day to the site. So basically they call at the end of their day, they tell us, you know, what they would like for their next delivery, and that morning it's brought out to their site. And then they basically will take the meals, and everything's all unitized. So it's basically all they need to do is grab one of the unitized meals along with the milk and pass it out to the students in line. It's basically they'll let us know how many meals they serve, whether it's breakfast or lunch, and the process repeats until their site date ends.
Sounds like you guys have a good sound process in order to actually achieve these goals.
Yep.
We're going to take a real quick break. We're talking about the summer food service program of the Child Nutrition Outreach Program. You can find more information at www.mealsforkids.org. You can also reach out on the phone, 617-723-5000. We're going to take a real quick break, and when we come back, we're going to talk about some of the successes that these guys have had. Stay tuned.
garbage pregnant woman where she did inside of Jessica. She lived in the city for years, becoming part of the community. An earthquake hit the area, and trucks both buried and discovered inside the city. Many have tried to find the black pile of gold, but they've all failed. Identifying the real life treasure is hard, even if you know exactly where the source is from. Thanks for watching this knowledge class. Hopefully, you learned a little something.
Welcome back to the Lynn Camp TV show. If you're just joining us, we're here talking about the Summer Food Service Program. And here with me today from the Child Nutrition Outreach Program, we have Ashley Krebs, Director of the Child Nutrition Outreach Program, and Kevin Richardson, a Senior Director of the Dining Services at the Lynn Public Schools. Now, we're here talking about this program that has been brought forth throughout the entire state of Massachusetts in order to create some awareness about nutrition for kids. As we all know, kids go through school throughout the fall, winter, and some of the spring, and then summertime, they're left to their own devices, and hunger is one of those. So in order to create some awareness and get some healthy meals out to these kids, we've got some great advocates like we've got here to actually achieve this. So first and foremost, just real recap, I would like to talk a little bit about, you know, the value that you guys bring forth. What can people expect from you? I mean, why does the organization exist? And I mean, who are you trying to help?
Sure. So, you know, as highlighted earlier, the Summer Food Service Program is intended to provide meals to youth over the summer months. You know, really it is intended for families that are suffering from food insecurity that rely on access to nutritious meals at no cost during the school year. And so, you know, as we highlighted earlier, really when the summer hits, a child should be able to worry about it just being a school vacation. You know, typically as you know, I remember fondly, like, oh, it's school vacation, it's an exciting time, summer's coming, let's play. Unfortunately, that's not, you know, the harsh reality is that's not the truth for every child. Some children really fear school vacations and fear summer months because they know that they might not have access to food. And so the summer program really speaks to that need and tries to address the need of ensuring that families have access to nutritious meals over the summer months. When we look at what to expect with the program, it looks at serving free meals for any child 18 or under at designated meal locations. So depending on the community, there's different places that children can go to get a meal. It really does vary community to community. It might be schools, libraries, parks, churches, etc. That's something that we work to with the community around, is identifying those locations that would be helpful and accessible to youth. And then they can arrive during designated meal times established by the sponsor to actually get the meal. So there's a variety of meals offered. Breakfast and lunch are the most common. Some communities do dinner Monday through Friday is again the most common. Some people have weekend meals. There's also snacks. And so that piece will really vary, and you can work either through contacting us and looking on our website or contacting the local sponsor directly to find out the details for your community. But the idea is that any child could kind of show up to this meal location or this site to receive a meal during that designated time. There's no identification required, no advanced sign up. You don't have to show up, you know, each day if you don't want. And although it's intended to meet the needs of those that might, you know, be suffering from food insecurity, truly anyone can participate. And so there's no overt identification. You know, a child can just be a child over the summer and go about their day without having to worry about where their next meal is coming from.
What kind of foods are in these lunches? I mean, I'm curious. I want to know. I mean, what kind of snacks do they get?
Well, as I mentioned before, it's a cold program right now. And they range from salads, so fresh salads, to like deli sandwiches. So, and then it comes with all the accompaniments, you know, as far as the sides. You know, you get your fruit, you get your vegetable, your fresh fruit, etc. And it comes with the milk.
Now, where does this food come from? For Lynn specifically?
Well, it does come from Lynn. We work with Preferred Meals, who provide the meals fresh daily. Okay. So they're actually made down in Woburn, Mass, and they're shipped up here daily.
Now, can you tell me off the top of your head where certain sponsors are located in Lynn?
Well, as of right now, we have 33 sites that will be operating throughout the city of Lynn. We have right now 16 of them that are what's considered open, which means anybody can go to those sites on those given days and times. We're always looking for more. So if there's any interest, if people are running programs, whether it be at churches, libraries, whatever it might be, that are looking to join in with the program, they can definitely call the information that you gave out as far as phone number and website.
Sure.
And we can get them hooked up.
Now, you guys have been around since 1975, the organization itself. So I want to talk about some of the successes that you've had. You've set out to feed children. Have you reached your goals?
Sure. So the Summer Food Service Program nationally was created back in 75. The Child Nutrition Outreach Program has held this outreach contract for over 20 years, and so we've been looking at increasing participation, which is our ultimate goal as a team. And we absolutely, there's always room for improvement, there's always work to be done, but we absolutely have seen trends upwards and reaching more kids each summer. Nationally, we are, ranked highly amongst other states in terms of the number of kids we're actually reaching. And so I think when you look at it both from an anecdotal and statistical perspective, I would say that we're doing a great job. And really that's owed to the sponsors at the local level for doing the work and getting the meals out to the youth and then having such a supportive administration statewide as well. So I feel like as a team, we're really proud of what we've been able to accomplish as a state. But at the end of the day, there's still more kids that could be fed, and so we won't feel happy until,
right,
we reach that goal.
Until the job's done.
Right.
That's how it should be. One thing that the next question I was going to ask is how you achieve this, and you pretty much answered that, and it comes down to the collaboration, the involvement with these communities. So it's good to know that, anybody in Lynn can receive a call someday from Ashley or anybody who works down there at the Child Nutrition Outreach Program and say, hey, we're looking for sponsors. Would you like to be a part of this? And once they join in, it's like, it makes your job a little bit easier. The collaboration is a huge, huge part of what
Absolutely.
You guys do. And it's like, if you don't have each other, it doesn't really work. I want to talk a little bit to Kevin. Now, continuous improvements. How long have you been doing this?
Well, I've been here working in the Lynn Schools for 8 years. But the program's been around probably for quite a long time, back in the 90s.
Yeah.
So it's been here, and it's been growing and growing each year, and it's just that continuous collaboration to go and outreach and get a hold of those sites and bring them on board and let people know that this benefit is there for those folks to take advantage of.
33 active sponsors in the city of Lynn, a population of 92,000, is an outstanding success. So what are you looking to do to improve on that?
Like I said before, to get more, there's the Lynn, we have in the public schools, we have about 15,000 students enrolled. So the opportunity is really great. And we're always looking for those sites. There's no limit on how many sites we can actually, have. So we're always looking to bring them on board and get them involved.
So we're here talking about the Summer Food Service Program of the Child Nutrition Outreach Program. What we're looking for are sponsors, places that will allow us to actually host and cater, I guess, so to say, for this Summer Youth Nutrition Outreach Program. And we're also looking to create some awareness about who can be involved and who can actually take advantage of these service, as well as creating awareness among some of the elected officials in the state of Massachusetts, and letting them know, hey, this is what we're trying to achieve. What can you help us do? How can you help us achieve our goal? So we've talked about a lot, continuous improvements. We've talked a lot about success. We've talked a little bit about your organization, who you guys are. I always like to know, just as people, what do you benefit from this? What do you get from doing your job?
So my background is in nutrition, and so for me, food insecurity is something that is very close to my heart. And so I feel like with the work that our team is able to do and the partnership we have with the Department of Elementary and Secondary Education, we can ensure that kids can be kids. They they can worry about everything else that goes into growing up, which I'm sure we can all relate to, but access to food is not one of them. And, you know, basic right that everyone should be able to know where their next meal is. So for me to know that I could potentially play a part in that in some removed way to ensure that access is something that I get out of it, I guess, on a personal level.
I have to kind of second that. It's, you know, going throughout the school year, you know, making it actually a full calendar year, you know, providing nutritious meals for the children of Lynn. You know, that's basically my goal. It's my department's goal. And, you know, that's what we're here for. So to be able to do that is really great.
Guys, you hit me in the feels. I'm hoping you hit everybody at home in the feels. Again, we're looking for sponsors. We need venues. We need people to help us actually achieve our goal. We're trying to create some awareness so that the participants can know where to find their next meal throughout the summer months, as well as reaching out to some of the primary leadership of our elected officials and let them know how they can help us achieve our goal. Guys, outstanding job. I really want to thank you for coming onto the program. Ashley Krebs, Director of the Child Nutrition Outreach Program. Kevin Richardson, Senior Director of the Dining Services at the Lynn Public School. We're talking about the Summer Food and Service Program of the Child Nutrition Outreach Program. You can find more information at their website, www.mealsforkids.org. You can also find them on Facebook and Twitter at Child N-U-T-R-I. That's it for the LinCam TV show. From the studio here at LinCam TV, I'm Sean Donahue, wishing you all the best.
Cool. So much.